AMD is definitely executing on its APU strategy. And, you know, even though we typically talk about the hardware, it's more than just the hardware. It's the IP, it's the software investment that they're making. You know, it is a complete strategy, corporate strategy, product strategy. It's not just a single device.
Designing, integrating, innovation, tailoring, and solutions are very key pieces of what we're investing in and where we want our products to go.
There are lots of guys making silicon that's intended for smartphones and trying to pull it up to more performance. And then there's guys making silicon for old client devices and trying to push it down into this space. We're actually focusing our dart right in that space, in that convergence area, having one device that can allow you to be productive and get things done and do work, and also have the media consumption with a great display and a great app ecosystem.
You know, when you start looking at Tamash and Kabini and Richland and this whole SoC strategy and everything else, you know, it represents a major milestone and a step forward to where we're going, and that's HSA.
We set the bar high, extremely high. I usually like to set the bar so high for engineers that they can't achieve it. In this case, they've exceeded my expectations. They exceeded, I think, everybody's expectations at AMD.
I mean, not only does it improve performance, but it enables a lot of the things that we're looking at for the future.
Things like ultra-high resolution displays, biometric recognition, being able to do facial recognition and speech recognition on mobile form factors at lower power. This is what we're trying to unlock with the APU.
So when you think about, well, what are the capabilities of these new Tamash, Kabini, Richland APUs, think about how they power these kinds of next generation experiences. What we're building with HSA, building it as a single chip that lets you take it into an amazing array of form factors, unleashes that, it accelerates that, it brings it even closer.
What we did with AMD, we actually converted most of the code to the GPU, to the OpenCL, and actually having the ability to offloading from the CPU and using the great power of the parallel processing and the image processing of the GPU to bring a whole new level of experience.
I want a computer that I can really just talk to and gesture to. I'd love to be able to get out of bed in the morning and instead of finding my iPhone or whatever my device is and hoping it still has battery and hoping I can read it, I just want to get out of bed and say, what's the traffic like on the 401 and what's my first appointment this morning? And I don't want to have a device, I don't want to worry about a battery, I just want computing that's there that I can interact with, just like Kirk on the bridge of the Enterprise.